They offer everything you need under the full moon. Check out the scary stuff for sale.
Come all ye tender Christians, wherever you may be, and likewise pay attention from these two lines from me. I was down at the depot to make my getaway, and Providence being against me, it proved to be too late. I tried to play off insane, but found it would not do. The people all against me, it proved to make no show. Judge Carlton passed the sentence, the clerk he wrote it down. On the 30th day of June, to die I was concealed. My name is George Stone, my name I'll never deny. To leave my aged parents to sorrow and to die. But little did I say, while in my youthful mood, I'd carry to the scaffold.
American citizens of German descent have, in this great crisis of our history, shown themselves splendidly loyal to our flag. Everyone had a right to sympathize with any warring nation. But now that we are in the war, there are only two sides, and the time has come when every citizen must declare himself American or a traitor. We must disappoint the Germans who have always believed that the German-Americans here would risk their property, their children's future, and their own necks and take up arms for the Kaiser. The Foreign Minister of Germany once said to me, "Your country does not dare do anything against Germany. We have in your country 500,000 German reservists who will rise in arms against your government if you dare to make a move against Germany." Well, I told him that might be so, but that we have 501,000 landholders in this country, and that was where the reservists would be hanging day after they tried to rise. And if there are any German Americans here who are so ungrateful for all the benefits they have received that they are still for the Kaiser, there is only one thing to do with it, and that is to hostile them. Give them back the wooden shoes and the rags they landed in, and ship them back to the fatherland. I have traveled this year over all the United States,
All a plain blood man that loved my friend.
I only tell you that which you yourselves do know. Show you sweet Caesar's wounds. Poor, poor dumb mouths, and bid them speak for me. But were I Brutus, and Brutus Antony, there were an Antony would ruffle up your spirit, and put a tongue in every wound of Caesar, that should move the stones of Rome to rise and mutiny.
Okay? Well, it better be because this is all the press life. And I've got a pretty nice program for my favorite little family. They're wandering down here to the Pacific Islands. The first request is made by none other than the boss. And guess what?
There was Bonnie Baker. And my assistant is from the boss. What tricks you have, sir? She said.
Everything you hold worthwhile is at stake. Only the hardest goals can
sacrifices. Invoking the spirits of our forefathers, the Army asks your unthinking support to the end that the high ideals for which America stands may endure upon the earth.
Would you like to hear the story of a girl that many soldiers know? It's a tale of love and all its glory they tell when the lights are soft and low. Underneath the lamppost by the barrack gate, standing all alone, every night you'll see her wait. She waits for a boy who marched away. Oh, promise you'll be true. Fare thee well, Lily, my lane, till I return to you. Fare thee well, Lily, my lane.
With the kiss she gave her promise to be constant as the stars above. Every soldier knows she's kept.
Our coming together is what we got to recognize very easy. You rightly. Among men resolved to accomplish has become the leader among men. When civilization itself has become a it is not to be challenged if government fails, when the excess of its cost robs the people of the way to happiness, the opportunity to achieve. If the finer sentiments were not urging, cold, hard, lack of incentive cost, and the elegance of economics would urge us to reduce our armies. If the concept of a better order does not appeal, then let us ponder the burden and the plight of continued function. It is not to be denied that the world has swung along throughout the ages without heeding this call from the kindlier hearts of men. But the same world never before was so tragically brought to realization of the utter futility of passionate sway when reason and conscience and fellowship quite a nobler way. I can speak officially only for our United States.
Frog went a-courting and he did ride. Ding dong, kitty kitty, cry me yo, with a sword and a pistol by his side. Ding dong, kitty kitty, cry me yo, cry mokey mo, cry mokey, way down yonder in a holler tree, and out in a bat and a bumblebee. Ding dong, kitty kitty. He rode till he came to Miss Mouse's door. King Kong, kitty, kitty, cry me, yo. And there he knelt up on the floor. King Kong, kitty, kitty, cry me, yo. Cry mokey, mo, cry mokey. Way down yonder in a holler tree. An owl and a bat and a bumblebee. King Kong, kitty, kitty, cry me, yo. He took Miss Mouse up on his knee. Ding dong, kitty, kitty, cry me, yo. And he said, little mouse, will you marry me? Ding dong, kitty, kitty, cry me, yo. Cry mokey, mo, cry mokey. Way down yonder in a holler tree. And out on the bat and a bumblebee. Ding dong, kitty, kitty, cry me, yo. Miss Mouse had sisters three or four. Ding dong, kitty, kitty, cry me, yo. And there they came right in the door. Ding dong, kitty, kitty, cry me, yo. Cry mokey, mo, cry mokey.
Better order which will vandalize the world. In such an accomplishment, there will be added glory to your flag and ours, and the rejoicing of mankind will make transcending music.